गुड आफ्टरनून गेविन। Okay, so around 51 students have joined. You can start now. Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So today I'm going to start with the first chapter of your syllabus, that is Introduction of Big Data. What is big data and what are the characteristics of big data? What are the types of big data? It's a general knowledge type of chapter, and which is there in your textbook by Radha Shankar Mani. It is not there in the other book. Okay, the contents of this particular chapter is taken from internet and your textbook, that is by Wiley Publication, Big Data Analytics ka book by Radha Shankar Mani. Okay, so we start. Okay, so big data, can you see this slide?
Yes,
Yes,
ma'am.
ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So let's start big data. So the objectives for today are that we are going to have the introduction. What is big data? What are the types of big data? And what are the characteristics of big data? Then how it is different from the traditional approach of doing analytics? Because why we are concerned with big data? Because we want to do the analysis and we want to find out some value out of it that will help in doing the business. So that's why we are interested in big data, because we want to do the analytics. So we need to know what is big data, what are the types of big data, what are the characteristics, and how it is different from our normal way of doing the analytics. Now, then the next thing is about what are the different sources from we collect this data, and what are the tools that are used in case of big data to do the analytics. And the case study. Okay, I think this is repeated. Case study or applications of big data. Okay, so whatever is possible, we'll try to cover. And in the here I have listed some of the questions which are asked in the exam. Like in the exam, they ask what is big data, what is Hadoop, and how big data and Hadoop are linked. Hadoop is the first framework that allowed us to store the big data in a distributed fashion. Distributed fashion on the distributed computers, okay, or clusters. Okay, so the question that is asked once in 2017 was for 4 or 5 marks, that explain what is big data and how big data and Hadoop are linked. Hadoop is a framework that allows you to store and process. So there are two operations which are involved. We have to store the data first, and then we have to process the data. And as I told you in the last lecture, that big data is so big that for your infrastructure, you are not able to handle this data, because the size is big. You don't have that much infrastructure to store the data, and you don't have that much capacity of CPU to execute or to process this data. So Hadoop is a framework that allows you to store this big data in a distributed fashion on the cluster or on the computers which are connected to each other, and then it allows us to do the processing or to execute this data to do the analytics. Okay, so normally most of the time on this particular chapter, always there is 5 marks question. Each and every paper will have at least 5 marks and maximum 10 marks of weightage is there for this particular chapter. Okay, so it's very important. Then the questions which are asked most of the times, like all these remaining 4 questions, there are things like what are the characteristics, what are the types of big data, and so the characteristics are nothing but this V's. Like this number of V's are going on increasing initially they started with 3 Vs, then 4 Vs, 5 Vs, and now to 10, 15 Vs are there, like volume, velocity, veracity. So we are going to learn about that. Okay, so I think you have understood the objective of the lecture. We are going to learn about what is big data, what are the different types and the sources of big data, what are the characteristics, how it is different from the other way of doing the analytics, and some case studies. Okay, right. So now let's understand first that big data is similar to big data, similar to small data. It is nothing different, like it is similar to small data, but maybe it is bigger in size and complex in nature. Why it is complex? Because it has both structured, semi-structured, unstructured data, and the data is growing so fast that our traditional relational database management systems or our conventional statistical tools are not able to handle this data, or they are not able to perform. So it is actually similar kind of data, but it is complex in nature, and the size may be big. So it is difficult to do the analytics. Now, how big is big? So as I told you last lecture, it is a relative term. For example, if I'm sending some 10 GB of file as attachment in my Gmail application, I'm not able to send that file, then it is a big data for me. Okay. Or if it is some terabytes of data, like 10 raised to 20 bytes of data for a pharmaceutical company, it may be a big data for the pharmaceutical company, but this terabytes of data is a small data for government agency, because even petabytes of data is considered as a small data for government organizations. So it is a relative term. Some data is big for some company, which is small for the other company, because they are having their infrastructure to handle the data. So whenever we are unable to a person or entity or any organization is unable to handle the size of the particular data, then it is a big data for that entity or that person or that organization. Okay, so what is, this is the actual definition which is there in the book, that big data is referred to a massive data set, it's a huge database, massive data set that is collected from a variety of data sources for business needs to reveal new insights for optimized decision making. Okay, so here what we are trying to say is that it is a massive data set that is collected from a variety of data sources. Because of the social media, now suppose you are having your internet connection such as Hathaway, so the customers are handled through their website, or they send the email. Customers can also interact with this Hathaway by using their website, or they can contact through WhatsApp numbers, or they are talking to their organization through their Facebook page, or they are talking through Instagram or Twitter. So like there are multiple different sources are there, and from where the data can be collected by any organization. For example, if you are having your own manufacturing company, or you are doing your own business, then you may have created your channels on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. You are having your website. You are having your customer care centers, call centers, and so these are the multiple places where you are interacting with your customers, and customers may talk to you or may reach to you through these social media handles. And then the data that is shared may be a different kind of data, and they may share a picture, or they may share a video, or they may share an audio, or they are sharing any unstructured text document. Okay, so what is this? Well, like big data is a massive data set, like different variety of data at different from different sources, and the size is big. If the size is small, then also we can manage, but the size, if it is a very famous organization, then there are multiple places or locations where the where your units are there, and customers are also more, like every second some customer is interacting with you. So in that case, it's very it's becoming a huge database. So we can go through the definition again, that big data refers to massive data set that is collected from a variety of data sources And why we collect it? Because of our business. Because we want to reveal some insight. We want to get some value, or we want to get some information that is useful for our business, for taking some decisions in the while doing the business. Okay, so what is there in this slide? We can summarize. Big data is similar to small data, but it may be a big, it may be bigger in size and complex in nature because of structured, unstructured, semi-structured kind of data, and it is a relative term. For some company, some data is big, which is small for the other company. Even today's big data will become a small data tomorrow because of available infrastructure and fast processing available. This way, I think you have understood about what is meant by big data. Okay, if you are not understanding, please, you can unmute yourself and talk to me, because it will be interactive session then. Now big data analytics is that this big data is stored for analysis to reveal hidden correlations and patterns. It is stored and we can do the analysis, but it is not possible to store on a single machine. So we store it on multiple computers in a distributed fashion, and we want to find out some hidden correlations and patterns. And this is proved that lots of organizations like Google, Facebook, they are doing such analytics since long back. Like, we were not aware about the analytics that time also. They started doing this analysis because they had the huge infrastructure. They had their own data centers and their own clusters where they used to store this data, and they are doing the analytics, but it was expensive. And nowadays, because of cloud computing, it is now not that expensive. So a startup can also do the analysis. So that's why now it is becoming famous. Big data analytics is becoming famous because we are having the infrastructure, tools available, open source software, everything is available. So a small company can also perform this analysis. Okay, and it is proven that the organizations have benefited a lot. Like, they have got millions of dollars profit by getting a small value or some small information from after analysis. Okay, they are doing the analysis, they are getting some value or some information, and they have used their information for their business, and it has helped a lot, and they have got a huge profit. So that's why everyone got attracted, and everyone is trying to understand the customer, and they are doing the analysis. So why it is possible? Majorly because of the evolution of technology. Like, initially we were using such landline phones. Now we are using mobiles, and we are sharing lots of information through mobile because of the social media. So data that is getting generated is huge. Okay, previously that much data was not getting generated. Now, initially we were using desktop machines. Nowadays we are using cloud computing, and we store the data on cloud, so the data is available now. Even we can perform the distributed processing. Initially we were using the small simple type of car. Nowadays a smart car is also there, and if the smart car is there, then there are multiple sensors or multiple things which are your car is interacting with all other devices, which like signal or some traffic related information from satellite. And so it is generating a huge amount of data. So because of this is just an example of evolution of technology. With the help of IoT and social media, now a huge amount of data is generated in each and every millisecond. People are generating data. Okay. So everywhere, whenever I'm reading the slides or any material, these definitions are there. That's why I thought that I have to write down this definition. You can use them when you are writing your papers. So as per this Gartner, he's saying that big data is a high volume, high velocity. High volume means the size is big. Velocity means the speed with which the data is generated is very high or fast, and a variety. So high volume, velocity, and variety of information that demands cost-effective and innovative forms of information processing. It's a other kind of information processing to get the insight. or this as per this orally this book, they are saying that big data, this definition I like this most. Big data is a data that exceeds the processing capacity of the conventional database systems. Even the computer ka memory as well as our existing databases like Oracle or MS SQL Server, or they are not able to handle this this data because it is a relational database and the data is very big. It is moving very fast. It doesn't fit into the structure of the database architectures. So to gain the value from this data, we have to choose some alternative way to process it. Okay, all these definitions are telling the same thing, like it's a huge data collected from multiple sources, high volume, high velocity, high variety of data, and that doesn't fit into the architectures of existing, or doesn't fit into the infrastructure, existing infrastructure. Even the normal database, RDBMS databases cannot handle them. And we want to gain some value because we want to do the analysis. Okay, as per this Forrester, big data is a frontier of a firm's ability to store, process, and access all the data it needs to operate effectively and make decisions and reduce the risks and serve the customers. Okay, so as per this Oracle, it is characterized by four key attributes. Volume, means there are four characteristics: volume, variety, velocity, and value. So now let's look big data in a different way. Okay, suppose if I want to, hello, are you understanding? Or is it too fast?
No, ma'am.
Okay. We are understanding, ma'am.
Okay. So suppose I'm comparing this data ka size with the grain of rice. So if we assume that one byte of information means one grain of rice, so now we can see that how much data is getting generated. A kilobyte can be a cup of rice, a megabyte can be 8 bags of rice, or gigabyte can be a 3 trucks full of rice, or terabyte can be 2 container ships, or petabyte is the Manhattan area, and then exabyte is a west coast of states that blankets of area, or zettabyte is a full of Pacific Ocean, that much amount of rice, and yottabyte is a earth size rice ball. Okay, so all these organizations, Facebook, Yahoo, Amazon, eBay, Google, they are generating yottabytes of data every day, or in some small amount of time they are generating so much of data. So this is the way like we calculate yottabyte, and uske aage to there is no measure. So byte, kilobyte, megabyte, gigabyte, terabyte, petabytes, till yottabyte, and this much data, byte and kilobytes, can be handled by a small device. Till gigabytes we can handle it by a small computer, and terabytes, petabytes we can handle it using internet, and after that it is becoming a big data, even if we have a proper infrastructure with a proper business organization. Okay, so that much data is getting generated now. So there are multiple organizations who are building their data centers to handle these yottabytes of information. Okay, and they are providing the services to us, so we can use them for some time, till the time, or like pay as per use. Okay, so now this big data is not about the size of the data, but it is about the value within the data. Like the size, so much of data is there, but we are not concerned with the size of the data. We are concerned with the value, the important information which we need. So we don't want everything. We want only some. We want to filter, or we want to get only the information which is useful for doing the business. Okay. So now, so what is meant by value actually? Okay. So value, like whenever everyone is now on social media because of the mobile and smartphones. So the society is leaving behind the digital footprint. Whatever we are doing on internet, everything is recorded. Don't think that like just you are sending any message and it's gone and it is only between these two people. Everything is stored somewhere and it is traveling through the internet. So we are leaving behind the digital footprints. We are creating our marks on internet or somewhere some data is stored. Okay, So people are living nowadays online. We are actually virtually living, and we are expressing our attitudes, our feelings, likes, dislikes, opinions, or our perspective about something. Or if even if we buy some product, if we like the product, we just send that via WhatsApp to the friend that this is a very good product. Or if you are frustrated, you will say that, like, today, since morning, my internet is not working. So I was frustrated that I'm trying with my mobile car data now. I don't know. So, like this, we are expressing and we are writing the messages on WhatsApp and via or Google, or we are sending the Gmail. And so we are expressing everything online. So we are generating huge amount of data. A single person or single person is generating huge amount of data in a day. Like these are some of the examples. Like in on the social media such as Facebook, Twitter, lots of information views are posted by millions of people across the globe. Okay, people are continuously sharing something on this social media. Every second, the information on is generated. Or if so everyone is using Google as a search engine or some other search engines, and they are firing the queries, and that queries are also stored and analyzed by Google because they want to improve their performance. So if it is a frequently asked query, you get the proper results within a fraction of seconds. Even your previous queries which you have asked, that are also stored. And so a huge information with respect to a particular person is stored by Google, Yahoo, or another messengers and searching. Or this is another example, such as it is a stock market. So where lots of people are doing online buying and selling of the shares, and all their decisions are stored. So it is also generating a huge amount of data about the people who are working in stock market. Or it can be, these are a few of the examples. Everywhere the data is generated. This is the example of air flight. So one particular air flight is also generating a huge amount of data, because each and every action of this pilot and crew is recorded. And even there are multiple components inside the aircraft. So each and every component car readings and its working and its level of working or its signals, everything is stored, and a single flight is generating a huge amount of data that is stored, and people are analyzing that. Okay, or if it is a GPS kind of thing, or this can be a IoT with a smart car, or if it is a Uber or Ola kind of vehicle, then also it is interacting with GPS system, and we get to know about this information about the availability of this vehicle, its model number, who is the driver, who are the customers, and then where is this vehicle is moving, which route it is following, what is the traffic. All such kind of data is also a huge data. Or this is another example of a power grid, where there are server and multiple nodes are there to generate the power. In that particular power grid co-location manufacturing unit, also there is lots of data that is getting generated. So the theme of this slide is to just to know multiple examples, like how big data is getting generated. Some everywhere data is generated and stored somewhere, and everyone wants to analyze the data because they want to improve their business. Okay, so this data is with the lots of information, so much of information it is there, but like how to process. So and but it contains lots of noise also. So everything is not important for us. If I'm a Hathaway business organization, then I'm not interested in each and every talk that a person is or my customer is doing. So lots of noise is there. That information is useless. So what is important is the ability to hear the signal from the noise. So what is the challenge is that I just have to know what is the important thing which is related to me, and I need to do store or filter, and then I need to analyze it. Okay. So how to do that? By unlocking the human conversation that is taking place around us. Like this helps a lot. WhatsApp or Facebook or Twitter is helping a lot for business organizations because they can understand their customers. Okay, so this listening to this conversation can lead us to we this means we can listen as an organization. We can listen to this conversation. And after listening this, which it can lead to some unexpected discoveries, like this is proven that you discover something which is very great for you to do the business. So the focus is on the business impact. And generally what we do in analysis is that we try something, we check that whether it is working or not, then we change it again, and we do or try to search or see from different perspective to the data. And then we are trying to get some information. If it is yes and if you are happy, then we stop. If you're not happy, then again you go back and you try to analyze the data and you try to find out something. So like this, it is a trial and error method always with analytics, and we are trying to find out some information for us. Okay. Now again, I'm referring the textbook. Like what is there in the textbook is that, so it is a collection of large data sets which cannot be processed using traditional computing technique. Okay. It's a huge data we cannot process by using traditional way. So now what is meant by exactly studying our big data? So studying big data means we are going to study about the tools. What are the different tools which are used to handle such a big data or massive data, which is coming from a variety of sources, which is of different type of data. And we also want to study what are the techniques, how to handle, how to store, how to process, what are the algorithms that are to be used, and what is a different new technique to solve a particular problem. Okay, we know that whenever we are doing matrix multiplication, we are using two for loops always. And with two for loops, sequentially, we are calculating each and every term of the resultant matrix. Okay, everywhere, whenever we have written down the program of matrix multiplication, we have used two for loops. And in two for loops, we are getting the first number, then you are getting the element 1, 1, then 1, 2, then 1, 3, then 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3. Like this, we go sequentially. But matrix multiplication problem is a very good example of a distributed processing, because each and every element of the matrix is not dependent on the sequence. You can calculate the last element before the first element, or you can calculate any particular element of the matrix at any time, because if you are having the proper values of ijk as an input to your function. So it is the best example of parallel processing, where parallelly you can calculate all the terms of the matrices. So the technique of calculation of or technique of doing anything is different in case of distributed processing. So we learning big data is that we want to learn the tools, we want to learn the techniques or algorithms, and we want to learn the frameworks which help us to do all these tasks. Okay. Now, so the firms such as Google or LinkedIn or Facebook, they are built around big data from the beginning. Okay, from initially only, as they become famous, they had this kind of thinking in their mind, and they created the data centers, and they are doing analytics since long time. Okay, so what is the idea behind this big data is that everything what we do is leaving the digital trace, and we or others can use this to analyze. Okay, so this is available now. With new information technologies, big data can bring about the dramatic cost reductions. Like why we are doing analysis? Because we want to reduce the cost of the manufacturing or supplying the goods, or we want to have some improvements with respect to time, or whenever we are designing any new product, that time also, for launching a new product, we can do the background study, and we can launch or we can provide new services. We can offer some services to the customer. So all such things are, these are the advantages of doing this big data analysis, that the cost is reduced, time is improved, and new innovative products can be launched or new services can be offered. So big data is the thing that is transforming the way we are doing the business and impacting most of the parts of our life. So it is actually the ability to make use of ever increasing volumes of data. Data will go on increasing, it will not decrease, it will keep on increasing. And so it's the ability to handle such data. So now I think the first part, that is what is big data, we've understood that big data is a massive data that is collected from variety of sources, and that it is a different type of data such as structured, semi-structured or unstructured data, and that we want to analyze by using some new tools, techniques, and frameworks, and we want to get the value. Okay. So now, what are the different sources? Actually, today's lecture is actually a general lecture because this information already we know. Everyone knows. Just a background or some general knowledge about big data. So one of the sources is activity data. Activity data means whatever the activities are happening, like transactions happening somewhere, that is generating a data, and it is captured by some devices, such as suppose you are listening to music, Amazon Music or Alexa or any music player. Then that digital music player, if it is connected to the internet or smart player, then it is generating a data. Okay, or if you are reading book online, then that ebook reader is also generating a data. Or if you are using a phone with a smartphone, or if you are searching the item, your browser is capturing the data. Or if you are doing any shopping, then your credit card company as well as the shopping cart website, they are capturing your data. So this is the activity data. You are performing some activity on internet, and that data is captured by the device and it is stored somewhere. Okay, then there can be a conversation data, such as the conversations are happening every day and they are having the digital trail. Okay, they leave the digital trail. For example, email or WhatsApp or Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, even whatever the phone calls we do, each and every phone call is recorded for some security purpose. We don't know, but it is recorded. Our phone conversations are recorded. So that is the conversation data, and if it is needed, it is used by the government. So this is, but it is stored somewhere, and they are doing some analysis on that. Or it can be a photo or video ka image data, such as your smartphones. You are sending images, videos, and sharing everything via YouTube, WhatsApp, Facebook. Okay. Then there can be a sensor data. Means the source of the data can be a sensor. If it is IoT, if it will start working full-fledged, then the amount of data will again exponentially increase. And right now, to GPS, or if your mobile may, if you switch on your GPS connection, then also your location-related data is stored. Okay. Or there are multiple devices which have sensors and which are continuously getting the data. Then IoT. Such as smart watch, fridge, alarm. Like we can visualize that there will be a smart fridge in few years, or it is already there. Like your fridge is connected to internet, and whenever there are no items in the fridge, it will there are sensors inside the fridge. It will identify that, okay, the vegetables are not there, only one vegetable is remaining. So that fridge will get connected, or it will make a call to a company such as a Big Basket, and then it will place the order which you have already informed to your fridge. It will place the order, and that Big Basket wala thing will communicate with your fridge. It will decide about the time of delivery, date of delivery, and even the payment related company is also connected to this fridge, and the payment can also be done automatically. Okay, so such things will happen, and it will generate a huge data. Okay, so IoT. Or traffic sensors is also one of the sources. So if the traffic sensors are working properly in a smart city, they can also talk to your alarm clock. If your alarm clock is a smart clock, the traffic sensors will have communication with the alarm clock, and alarm clock will wake you up earlier, because suppose there is a traffic on a particular route on which you travel, and if the sensors identify that, okay, today there is a heavy traffic, so that will communicate with your alarm clock, which will wake you up earlier because of the traffic, and because you need to reach on time for the meeting or your office. Okay, so such things are going to generate a huge amount of data. Even these are some other examples, like chatting of the social network, then audio streams, MP3, government documents which are scanned, or automobiles, or web server logs, satellite images. They are also generating huge data. Banking transactions, GPS, financial markets, and the web pages. So this will be the input to your big data system. So this I just placed it because this thing is there in your textbook. So this diagram shows that such variety of data is taken and you want to analyze and you want to get the value because of these advantages. Like what you want to do, you want to spot the trend, new business trend, or if it is a research paper, you want to determine the quality of the research, or what are the citations, or if it is a healthcare application, then you want to prevent the disease by predicting the disease. Then pharmaceutical company can in advance identify and they will manufacture the medicines for that. Or if it is a police department, they want to combat the crime. Or if it is a business organization, they want to launch a new product. Or you want to determine the traffic conditions. So like this, everyone and each and every field, everyone will be benefited if the proper analysis is done. Okay, and so these are the people, like these are some examples who are doing this analysis, like marketing agencies to do lots of analysis, companies, retail organizations, hospitals, weather conditions, police department, banks, everyone is trying. Okay, so now what is the challenge? This was about big data and from where it is generated. What is the challenge? So whenever you do analysis, you have to store the data and you do some pre-processing on the data. So like for such kind of big data, which is unstructured, how to capture it, how to do the pre-processing or curate your data, how to store, how to search within that data, then how to, suppose you want to share something, then how to share it or transfer this data from one place to another, and how to visualize, search everything, each and every step, there are challenges. So the challenges includes in each and every place, but we are now following the new approaches. People are working on that and they came up with open source tools, open and new techniques, algorithms, and hardware infrastructure. So now it is possible. So it was possible before by Google and Walmart, but with the cost was very high. But now with the commodity software, now in this big data analytics, we are using this term commodity software and commodity hardware, like again and again. So commodity hardware means a cheap computer, a normal computer which comes at a normal price where there is a CPU and normal memory is there. So with such device and with open source software, that means a commodity hardware and software. So with such, I think here I have to write commodity hardware and here open source software. So now with the commodity hardware and open source software and with the cloud infrastructure, now it is possible for startups also to extract the hidden information from big data. Okay, anyone has any doubt in this?
No, ma'am.
Okay, so I think 60 people are there actually on my board. I'm seeing that 60 students are there, but I don't know exactly how many are actually listening. Okay, so this big data is possible because of social network, mobile computing, and cloud computing. This is a result. This is a result of this three trends. Because of these three trends, this big data is a result. Or they are generating. So this is again the same thing where initially only ERP system was there, then people started doing ERP was there, then customer relation management they added to that some websites, and with the social media now big data is generated. So this diagram is just to see that initially in old days only some megabytes of data was getting generated, and nowadays easily petabytes of data is generated by a particular business organization. So this tells you about the types of big data. These types are like structured data or your operational data, such as if you are having a proper relational kind of table with some fixed data types such as float, integer, character, strings, then it is a structured data and it is available in a data warehouse. So we are doing big data analytics. That does not mean that this data warehouse is out of like it is old. Still, it is there. So the big data will include the data which is there in the data warehouse also. Okay. So the structured data is a part of data warehouse data which you can analyze. Or it can be a semi-structured data such as XML data or RDF data. For example, XML documents are used to store information. at multiple places. Enterprises are doing using XML because of its advantage of interoperability. Whenever you want to transfer data from one place to another, XML is a very good way to transfer the data or very good way to represent your data. And it is extensively used in integration of heterogeneous data. If your Oracle data is to be integrated with your MS SQL Server data, then XML is an easy way to integrate such heterogeneous information. So enterprises are using extensively XML data. Plus RDF data is for the next version of Web, but still some people have started working with semantic Web, which is Web 3.0. And where the data is stored in the form of a graph, or it is actually in the form of XML kind of document. Graph. If we want to see this RDF data in the form of a diagram, it is like a graph. But actually, when you write a program, it is, or if you see the document and open the document, text document of RDF, it is similar to XML, some semi-structured data. So this is also getting increased, and it is also there as a part of big data. So your data, existing data of your data warehouse is a part of big data or type of big data. Then XML and RDF is also a big data. Even the streaming data is also getting, is a part of big data, where your videos are streaming for phone conversation, audio, video, continuous real-time streaming. And when the network traffic data is also a stream data, which is continuously generated and we cannot store it. And it is so fast that there is no way to store such data. Okay, or sensor data. So, and then unstructured data is about audio, video, images, logs. Log is in the form of a text document, but there is no proper structure, or a blog or a forum or social networking site or clickstream. Clickstream means that whenever whenever you are visiting any particular website, the website administrator or the developer, they create a clickstream for you. For every user who is logging in or who is accessing the website, each and every click of the user is stored. So they keep the log about it. So you clicked on the back button, then you were looking at the catalog, then you selected that, you spent 5 minutes on that catalog, on that particular product, and then you close the browser, or you liked it, or something like this. They keep each and every information about each and every click till you log out or till you switch off your browser. So this is also a huge data, and it is unstructured. Okay, so these are the types. So what are the types? Structured, unstructured, semi-structured, real-time, is, and you can elaborate on this. Okay, so now I think how much time is left? Okay, so now this is about the next topic is about the characteristics of data. So the first characteristic of your data is volume. The size is big, like huge data. And so in 1 minute nowadays, this is also old information, like 12 terabytes of data is generated by this in every day. Nowadays, so it is petabytes only, log data. The log data, tweet data, or Google is having so many tools, Google Talk, Google search engine, then their drive is there. They have so many tools, their classroom is there, and so much of data is there. Then, so the volume is big. Volume is the size of the data. Second characteristic is about the speed with which the data is generated. So suppose something, some message is there, it goes viral very fast. Or if there are some scientific instruments, then they are also generating the data very fast, or these devices. So the second characteristic is about velocity. So the speed with which the data is generated is very fast, and it is moving also very fast. So it needs to be processed very fast. Okay, then the progress and innovation is no longer hindered by the ability to collect the data. So that such kind of analytics is similar to the OLAP, online analytics. And if we miss, like if you take late decisions, if you are slow in collection of the data as a business organization, then you may lose the opportunity. Okay? Because if you are very, data is generated very fast, so lots of data will be wasted or if you are getting the data, storing, and then after some days you will do the analytics, and by that time the market will change, and your purpose of doing the analysis will not be solved. Okay, by that time a new requirement is there in the market. And if you are having a competitor business organization, if they are doing the analysis very fast, they may launch a new service before you. Okay, so it is not allowed. Only if you are doing business, it is not allowed to take the late decisions. You cannot miss the opportunities. You have to capture the data fast and you have to analyze the data fast, so that you can do some promotions, like, or you can provide some services or anything, and you can survive in the competitive business market. Okay, so business market is very competitive. You have so many competitors in, if you are doing the business, so they may come up with the new schemes before you. Okay. The third characteristic is about the variety. Like, what is variety means? Different type of data. So here again the listing is there: relational database, then text data, then XML data, graph kind of data, such graph data, or the semantic web data, or the streaming data, or it can be photo, video, audio recording, and a single application can be generating or collecting many types of data. So you will store this, and to extract the knowledge we have to link all these different types of variety of data. Okay, so you have to whenever you are considering the entire data for your analysis, you are considering the audio files, video files related to you, or your text files, or your relational database, and then you are integrating them and linking with each other. So RDBMS is definitely is not able to do this. Okay, so you have to store and access it quickly, and this unstructured data is increasing exponentially. The third characteristic is about the variety, which I talked earlier. Then the fourth characteristic is about fourth characteristic is about veracity. Veracity means the trustworthiness of data. Like your data should be taken from a reliable source. It should not be a fake data. Otherwise, your analysis will be wrong. Or the quality of data should be good, or it should be accurate. Or so like this, or there are in the Twitter messages, someone may use abbreviations or hashtags or typo or some other terms. So you need to work on that. That is called as veracity. And the last characteristic is about the value. From such a high volume, fast moving data with the different variety and veracity, we have to turn it into a value which is useful to us. So the values is the fifth characteristic. So as per like here, what are the different types of values which are generated? Like Amazon or Netflix, they may do the recommendations by understanding the customers better way. Or if it is a Uber application, they can predict the demand, and they can dynamically change the prices, and they can send the closest driver to the customer. So this is a value because they are optimized their processes. Or the other example can be a government agency can predict some outbreak, flu outbreak, and they can track, and the pharmaceutical companies can launch the medicine. Or it can be, if it is a government agency or police department, they can predict some terrorist attacks and they can detect the cyber crime. Or if it is a sports related applications, then the sportsman can analyze the previous matches. They can see, because of these cameras and GPS trackers, they can analyze and improve upon their style. Or they can study their opponent's style of playing, and they can decide how to play with that particular player. So all this is, so we can in short say that each and everywhere we can get some value. Okay, so this is in short form. So there are five. So as per, we are not going to and studying about the remaining like multiple Vs. For us, as per the scope of the syllabus, we are concentrating on five Vs: volume, velocity, variety, veracity, and value. Okay, so where the volume is the size, where length indicates what are the sources, how to integrate them, from where to collect. Breadth indicates about the and how much depth we are going to do the study or analyze the data. And depth means the actual analysis of the value, and the velocity is the data upload speed, variety is different type of data, and veracity is reputation, availability, accountability, authenticity of data, and value is some patterns, hidden patterns. Okay. So I think we can stop now. Okay, so any doubts? Please, you can reply on chat. Any doubts till now? So what we studied today, can anyone summarize? Aman Bahati. Aman, can you unmute yourself?
Shall I?
Yeah, yeah.
So we started with the introduction of big data, which you explained to be which is basically the which is like small data, but it is bigger in size and complex. And you also mentioned that big data analytics refers to the analysis of big data to reveal hidden correlations and patterns that will help us reveal new insights for optimized decision making.
Correct.
So that you after that we saw five formal definitions of big data by Gartner, O'Reilly, Forrester, and Oracle, and a fifth one that I don't remember. Each of them varying, but having the same basic concept, that is, big data is defined by high volume, variety, and information that once analyzed can help help companies make better decisions. So we understood the different sizes that that you see in big data. For example, one byte, if you consider to be equal to a grain of rice, then you have so on different other measurements such as kilobytes and megabytes that can vary to different sizes of quantities of rice. So on and so forth, which we learned about yottabyte, which is an Earth-sized rice ball, which is usually the amount of data that is generated by companies like Yahoo and Facebook, Amazon, etc.
Okay.
Then you showed us examples of big data. For example, they're used in social media platforms like Facebook and Instagram and Twitter to generate information or views posted by millions of people across the globe. Then others are, for example, power grid data, where the information is consumed by a particular node with respect to the client itself. Then we also saw about CVR, which is the voices of flight crew recordings of the microphone, and so on. About six examples we saw of big data. Then we explained big data more to see that it's a collection of data sets that cannot be processed with using traditional computing techniques. And companies like Google, LinkedIn, etc. have already been doing big data analytics from a long time, but because it was expensive, a lot of companies were not able to get in on it. And now that it has become a bit more affordable, even startups can go in and use big data analytics to make better decisions for themselves.
Correct. So you have understood the lecture. I am really happy with such a proper answer with you. So now I may take one more lecture on this big data, because some case studies are remaining and applications are remaining, and after that I'll start with the Hadoop. So I want to tell you that you don't miss the lectures of Hadoop and HDFS, where we learn about how this data will get stored and how it will be distributedly processed. So that is the theme of the subject. Once you understand that particular storage of data on HDFS, Hadoop distributed file system, and one sample application of that, one exercise of handling this data, then it is easy to understand the remaining topics of the syllabus. Okay.
Okay.
So Thank you. So we'll see tomorrow. Tomorrow, I think, tomorrow is the lecture.
Okay. Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. See you tomorrow.